In these examples, we'll determine the reference angle for the given angles. The reference angle is the acute angle formed by the terminal side of the given angle and the x-axis. So let's go ahead and start by sketching this angle in the standard position. So here's the initial side of the angle. We'll rotate counterclockwise 221 degrees. So if we rotate from here to here, that's going to be 180 degrees. So now we'll have to rotate another 41 degrees counterclockwise. So the terminal side of our angle would be somewhere in this position. So the acute angle formed by this terminal side and the x-axis would be this angle here, and the measure of this would be the measure of the reference angle. So if this was 180 and we rotated 41 degrees more, then 41 degrees is our reference angle. So to indicate the reference angle, we often use theta prime, and again, that's 41 degrees. The reason reference angles are so important is if this angle here is an angle in one of our special reference triangles, like 30, 60, or 45, we can construct the reference triangle by sketching a perpendicular from the x-axis to the terminal side, and we can use this reference triangle to determine trig function values. Let's take a look at two more examples. Here we have 347 degrees, so let's go ahead and sketch it in standard position. Again, we're going to rotate clockwise 347 degrees. This rotation here would be 270 degrees. So if we subtract 270 degrees, we have to rotate another 77 degrees. We know this is 90 degrees, so we're going to rotate maybe somewhere to here. So this would be the terminal side of our angle. So if this angle here was 77 degrees past the negative y-axis, then the acute angle formed by the x-axis and the terminal side would be formed by this ray and this ray. So our reference angle, this angle here, would have to be 13 degrees. So theta prime is equal to 13 degrees. So from here, if we needed the reference triangle, we would just sketch a perpendicular from the x-axis that intersects our terminal side. Let's take a look at one more example where theta is negative. Here we have theta equals negative 125 degrees. So from the initial side of the angle, we'll rotate clockwise 125 degrees. So rotation from here to here would be negative 90 degrees. So now we have to rotate another negative 35 degrees. Maybe somewhere in here. So again, this piece here was 90 degrees, and this rotation here was 35 degrees. And the reason that's important is if we take a look at the acute angle formed by the x-axis and the terminal side of the angle, this angle here is our reference angle. So if this is 35 degrees, the angle formed here would be 55 degrees, and this is our reference angle. So again, from here, if we needed the reference triangle, we would just sketch a perpendicular from the x-axis that intersects the terminal side of the angle.